Thank you, Dr. Arun, and very good afternoon to all of you. As Dr. Sood was telling that a patient with cataract having glaucoma and wants to get his surgery done, so it's a great dilemma what to do, go for a combined surgery or a cataract surgery alone or TRAP surgery alone with sight. All these are dilemmas which will be answered in subsequent lectures. So I'll be discussing about the preoperative evaluation of a case of cataract with glaucoma. So what is our ultimate goal? It should be to achieve the good visual outcome after cataract surgery with long-term glaucoma control. So what are the questions to be answered? So whether there is a need for surgery, if yes, it will depend on to determine the degree of visual disability. It is either from the cataract or it is from the glaucoma. And what is the urgency of surgery, whether combined surgery is needed or cataract surgery, which surgery is to be done first and what is the urgency behind that. So cataract alone, combined surgery, if combined in one side or two side, these will be discussed by the subsequent instructors. So what are the factors which will help in the decision making? So what is the type of glaucoma? What is the level of IOP control? What are the drugs which the patient is using? And what is the severity of optic nerve damage? So these are the factors which will help in the decision making. So these are the indications for cataract surgery will be discussed. I will not go in the detail of this. I am just talking about the briefing and introducing the topic. And if the patient has a visually significant cataract, then all these parameters will be talked about subsequent speakers. So now I directly come to the preoperative assessment. So first of all, you should see the conjunctiva. When we come to the examination, history part is one thing. So whether previous filtration surgery is done or not, what is the condition of conjunctiva, because that will determine the prognosis of the post-operative TRAP surgery. So whether there is some scarring or patient has undergone RD surgery and if there is a buccal and conjunctiva is fibrous there. So you have to be very careful. I know that most of the anterior segment surgeons, when they do bulk surgeries, means they forget to look up to the superior part of the conjunctiva, what is the condition of the conjunctiva. So one has to be very careful in examining the patient. Sometimes the anti-glaucoma drugs can also alter the condition of the conjunctiva, and there can be fibrosis and scarring there. So what it will cause? If there is a scarring, it will be very difficult to do conjunctival dissection. Post-operative outcome of the TRAP surgery will depend on that. Then the risk of increased bleeding will be there. Then we come to the cornea. As you know that it is a very important structure of the eye. So whether there is epithelial or stromal edema, it can be because of bullous keratopathy or raised IOP, or sometimes because of ICE syndrome also. You have to observe the endothelium of the cornea, whether there is any inflammatory signs because of uveitis or Fuchs hydrocyclitis. What is the level of endothelial condition? You should do specular microscopy if you have, but even if you don't have, then you can see the guttae and all those things and you can evaluate the endothelium. Then coming to the pupil, one has to be very careful in examining the pupil, the size of the pupil, the reaction of the pupil, whether there is a proper dilatation of the pupil or not. Patients on chronic use of pilocarpine may have difficulty in dilating the pupil. So it will cause difficulty in capsular axis also, and it will prelude to the anterior chamber. If need arise, then IOL implantation also. So anterior chamber, it is very important to examine the anterior chamber preoperatively. One should observe the depth of the anterior chamber, whether there is any activity in the anterior chamber, cells, flare, etc. So AC depth should be, if it is less than 2.4 millimeters, then it increases the risk of angle closure when you dilate the pupil. Then anterior chamber depth asymmetry may give you an alarming sign of weak zonules, or you have to also look for pseudo exfoliation. So as I told you that anterior chamber depth asymmetry is an alarming sign of zonular weakness. You have to look for phacodonesis or iodonesis, or some subluxation, visibility of lens equator on eccentric gaze. You have to see very carefully in such patients because the zonules are very weak in chronic glaucoma patients. Then you should go to optic nerve head. You examine the neuroretinal rim, and as we evaluate each and every patient for the disc and disc-related changes in the glaucoma patients, and these all factors will depend on the future prognosis and visual outcome. Whether the eye is vitrectomized or it is a silicon-filled eye, then also the outcome will be vary in such cases, and it can precipitate the posterior subcapsular lens opacities. It can cause secondary glaucoma, altered biometry. So these all factors one has to take into consideration when we are evaluating a cataract patient who is having a coexisting glaucoma. They are very important. One should not be very casual about it. Then what preoperative drugs the patient is on, like prostaglandins, it can cause early, in the early post-op period, it can cause CME. Then chronic use of pilocarpine, it will result in a small pupil. These points will be addressed by subsequent speakers, that what are the IUL choices. Now coming to the investigations, intraocular pressure is the single most factor which has to be considered. Sudden lowering of IOP sometimes can during surgery is a raised preoperative IOP, increase the risk of suprachoroidal hemorrhages. Gonioscopy is very must, and it should be done in each and every case in which there is a coexisting glaucoma in cataract patients. Ultrasound biometry for AC depth and axial length. Then UBM is a very important tool which should be done to see the angle structures and to diagnose whether it is an anophthalmic or a high hyperopic eye. In which there is a cataract is not very significant, and if you can do field analysis, it is very, very important prognostic factor, and you can explain the patient about the post-operative visual outcome also. Specular microscopy, as I told that not every doctor has a specular microscope, but if you do a very good slit lamp examination, you can know the health of the endothelium with the high resolution and high power, high magnification. Pachymetry is a very important tool. Anterior segment OCT can also be done if you don't have a UBM. Then ultimately the unrealistic expectations should be, especially in the advanced glaucoma, should be explained to the patients. A proper counseling to the patient should be done, that there can be what is the visual prognosis of the patient, whether you are doing a single surgery, whether there is a need of second surgery is there or not in the future, and what will be the best corrected vision. These all unrealistic expectations should not be given, and a proper counseling should be done. Thank you very much.